the spotlight is 10 times brighter and 10 times harder than I thought it was.
There is a code of conduct for the reigning Heisman winner, and he violated it once again. This is just out of bounds behavior for a reigning Heisman winner.
I tell you, he is out of control.
It's important that Johnny Football understands that the time for giving him a pass is over. This is unacceptable stuff.
Still gonna do things that everybody in college does, and I'm gonna continue to enjoy my life. Hopefully, people don't hold me to a higher standard than that, but I am still in college and I am still going to live my life to the fullest.
He has shamed that trophy and shamed college football in general with his behavior.
Johnny Manziel's antics on the field today were simply inexcusable.
If he's not the most selfish, easily manipulated knucklehead in recent memory in college football, I don't know who is.
If he hasn't gotten the message thus far, what's happened with the NCAA and the investigation, he's never going to get it.
This guy is a detriment to this team mentally. He had better be very good physically, because right now he's acting like an embarrassment.
He's been the same punk from the beginning.
That has all the makings of something that could tear a team apart.
Johnny Football said the three people he would like to party with.
I'm gonna have to go with Charlie Sheen, Rob Gronkowski, and Tiger Woods to the mix.
Those three might not be able to keep up with Johnny Football. Bottom line is, Manziel only knows one way to live, and that's full go. That's I'm gonna be who I am. I don't care what anybody else thinks.
Now this looks like a top for me, so everybody just follow me, cause we need a little controversy, cause it feels so empty without me. I said this looks like a top for me, so everybody just follow me, cause we need a little controversy, cause it feels so empty without me.
This time Johnny Manziel sought trouble.
Did you drink alcohol while you were there at all?
I'm not going into the details about what happened.
All of this that we're talking about is actually a reason why I love this kid. He's got daredevil in him. He plays daredevil football. He will try anything at any moment, and most of the time he gets away with it.
He's a 20-year-old kid. He's enjoying college. He's the Heisman winner. He has life on a string.
One of the reasons that he plays so well is because he is a fiery, emotional guy, and you don't want to put a lid on that.
Trash talk doesn't distract Johnny Manziel. It fuels him.
Incidentally, talking about Johnny Manziel, how does a college kid get courtside seats to a Mavs game? Those are expensive seats.
This looks like a top for me, so everybody just follow me, because we need a little controversy, because it feels so empty without me. I said this looks like a top for me, so everybody just follow me, because we need a little controversy, because it feels so empty.
Out of bed this morning at 10 o'clock, put on SportsCenter, watch Lou Holtz rail on him, watch Mark May, put over here, watch you guys, and he's loving it.
I feel like I am on a little bit higher pedestal than most people in college football. I think everything I do is pretty much everywhere in the world, so the people don't know about
it. If you can watch one player in college football play, you want to watch Johnny Manziel.
Just go out and win, find a way to win, whatever it takes. That's what I'm doing for my team.
It just seems everybody only wants to discuss me. So this must mean I'm disgusting. But it's just me, I'm just obscene. Hey, I'm not the first king of controversy.
Hey, make some noise for Johnny Manziel right here, ladies and gentlemen. Turn the fuck up!
If I've really set a legend, I don't know if that's really, it's kind of more of a folk tale, I guess, right now for me.
This is the even longer ball.
Buckets!
Oh my gosh.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh, Johnny! Johnny! He's a machine! Oh my God!
I've just continued to be living my life. I'm continuing to grow up. I've made some mistakes, and I'm absolutely manning up for those. Some things that I regret, some things that I think were blown a little bit out of proportion, but at the end of the day, that's just how it goes, and you have to live with that. But I'm growing up, continuing to try not to make the same mistake twice.